हाय फ्रेंड्स, टुडे लेट्स सॉल्व क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू ऑडियो वीडियो सिस्टम्स व्हिच इज आल्सो कॉल्ड ईएमसीजी इन सी16 सिलेबस. नाउ लेट्स सॉल्व क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू दिस इन 2017 तेलंगाना ईसेट क्वेश्चन पेपर. सो द आउटपुट ऑफ ए वर्टिकल एम्पलीफायर अप्लाइड टू द योक इन ए टीवी रिसीवर कंसिस्ट ऑफ, इफ यू सी इट, इट इज अ सॉटूथ करंट. So basically vertical scanning current. So in vertical oscillators, they use an RC network to develop a sawtooth waveform. And with this as an input to a vertical amplifier, you will be getting a sawtooth current through the vertical deflection coil. So the vertical output stage is a power amplifier. Next. In United States, the television broadcast standard is, basically it is NTSC. NTSC is National Television System Committee, and it is an analog television color system which is introduced in North America in 1954. So it is one of the three major television standards, which are PAL and CCAM. Next, the input used by an antenna or a cable to a TV set uses frequencies called radio frequencies. So these are used in communication devices such as transmitters, receivers, computers, televisions, mobile phones. So if you observe, RF is also applied in carrier current systems including telephony and control circuits. Next, the aspect ratio of a HDTV is, it is generally 16:9. Now 16:9 is a widescreen aspect ratio in which width is 16 units and height is 9 units. So common aspect ratio in case of televisions and computer monitors is also the international standard format of HDTV or full HD and SDTV. So these are the questions related to EM audio video systems in this particular question paper. So let's also solve questions related to audio video systems or EMCG as per C16 syllabus in Telangana ESET question paper. Now the first question, which of the following camera tubes uses lead oxide? So the solutions of these questions are prepared by me, and you can access this particular PDF through the link provided in the description of this YouTube video. So observe this. The question is lead oxide. It is in a, what is it, Plumbicon camera tube. So every year there are questions based on Plumbicon. Try to remember this. So camera tube uses lead oxide in Plumbicon for photoconductive target plate. So I'll show you the diagram once again. You observe this. This is the lead target plate which is in a Plumbicon. The structure is relatively similar to our television. So which of the following is the most negative electrode in electron gun? So in an electron gun, the control grid is given negative potential relative to cathode in order to repel electrons, thus to control the number of electrons passing through it. So control grid 1 will be doing the work. I will try to show you the pictorial representation of this. So see this. If this is your electron gun, you will be having control grid 1 which will be doing the above functionality, which is generally most negative to the electron gun. Next, who invented the method of recording sound on flat disc? So basically Emily Berner, he invented this concept which is used in telephone technology, and it is developed as a phonograph record. So previously also Emily Berner has invented gramophone, in which the mechanical predecessor to the electric record player. Next, so in color picture tube degaussing is done. What is degaussing? Degaussing is demagnetization counteracting the effects of Earth's magnetic field or of electromagnetic fields produced by the nearby electrical devices such as motor or planes. So basically it is done by a 60 hertz alternating current. So the method, so degaussing is basically a method in which the magnetic domains in metals or magnetic inclusions in materials are randomized so that the magnetization is, so you are going to reduce the magnetization. So one tool to do this is by this method, bulk tape eraser. So in this method, bulk tape eraser, we generate an alternating electromagnetic field which flips the magnetization of the magnetic domains at 100 to 120 reversals per second or 50 or 60 hertz. So by this we will be reducing the magnetic field. Next, in NTSC standard, the total number of equalizing pulses are, if you observe, they are 12 in number. So a narrow pulse is superimposed on vertical blanking pulses of a composite TV signal before and after the vertical synchronizing pulse. So the number of equalizing pulses depend on the identification requirements for even and odd vertical synchronizing pulses. Okay, with this, all the questions related to audio video systems or EMCG are completed in 2018 question paper.